Hello, welcome to Pete's Garden episode 4. Thank you for watching. In this episode I'll be planting peas, which means that's the first time I'm planting something outside this year, so good. And a few days ago I took part in the RSPB Big Garden Birdwatch, and I'll show you how I got on with that. Right. First of all, if you want to click subscribe, that would be very much appreciated. But for now, roll titles. So, time to take part in the RSPB Big Garden Birdwatch. And as I'm doing that, time to refill bird feeder. It's actually not squirrel proof, we found this bird feeder, so I've got another one coming, but I'm going to put that up there and let's see if any birds sit on that perch in the next hour, because that's what the whole country's doing this weekend as I'm talking to you. They're logging the amount of birds that you actually see in your garden for the next hour. Now this year I've sown two types of peas. One sugar snap pea, which is a climbing variety, and these, which are pea Feltham First. They're a very good early variety, and most of them have come through. There's three pots which haven't quite come through yet. They're showing through the top, but they're not as big as that. So I'm going to put these ones in now, and the other ones in later on, which means digging over a part of this bed. So, I have now dug it over once with the spade, once with the fork, and also I've gone through it with the little four-pronged cultivator tool, which is quite good as well for getting rid of most of the clumps, and I'm now ready to plant. If you're wondering why my finger appeared in shot there, didn't it? If you're wondering why I'm not planting to the right here, it's because in the spring this area is going to be laid with grass to match this area over here, so that it's a bit safer to walk around. So I'm sowing the peas in here, or planting them in here I should say. All I'm doing is I'm going to dig a little trench all along this row. Now I must admit the soil isn't absolutely ideal, because ideally it would be a fine till with no weeds and all that, but this soil will still do perfectly well. And some of the people on YouTube have theirs in guttering, don't they? Oh look, there's a little slug, whoops, I'll get rid of him. Hey, it's a slippery thing. Let's get rid of him, there we are, got rid of him. Some people on YouTube, like a lot of diary and everything, have theirs in guttering, and I can see why. That might be the preferable way to do it, I think, but I just do not have the space for the guttering here, so I'm doing it in pots, but I haven't had to rip those roots. If you notice, they came away voluntarily. Let's get that weed out of the way. So I put these about 10 centimetres apart, and I'll probably do the rows about 10 centimetres apart as well. And actually, I should have done this trench a little bit deeper, so I will for the rest of the row, because you want it to go nice and deep. And you want the actual pea at the roots to be covered. And I'll just finish this off and then put the pea sticks as well in, which I haven't put in yet, because if you put them in first, then I tend to it can be a bit hazard. So I'll put those in and show you what it looks like at the end. And so this is what it all looks like when it's done. Normally, I would put the pea sticks or bean canes in second after planting to avoid damaging the roots. But the pea plants were so, the roots of them were so small at the moment that it was better to do the pea sticks second, otherwise they would have been a hazard, as I said earlier. So I've put in a row, which you can see down there, and three plants in the second row. And as I also said earlier, I will put the plants that are not that big yet, when they are, I'll put them in and fill up the second row. And I've got two uses for the pea sticks. One, obviously, is that the peas will hopefully climb up them, and the second one is that you've seen me scatter them around the edges there. That stops the birds, or should stop anyway, the birds from coming and pecking at them. And these are pea feltham first, and planted now. They should be ready at the end of May, and we'll get at least a few good pickings off of that. He's a nice little robin. I can't quite tell from here. Oh, it might be a starling. Where is he? Have I got him on camera? Oh, yuck. Aren't they lovely? Where's he gone? Well, we're in the last few minutes of my hour of the Big Garden Bird Watch for 2016, and so far we've only had the female chaffinch. That's the bird I think that I showed you a bit earlier, or just now, whenever I put it in. So bit of a disappointing year this year. We've had far fewer than last year. And the video for that, for last year's one, is in the description box below if you want to watch that. But then, to be fair, the RSPB did say that it would be the number of birds actually landing in the garden would be lower this year, because it's been a milder winter and the birds have had more wild berries to choose from, and so therefore they're not so reliant on these things as they would be if it was a more severe winter. So there we are. And it's only, well, certainly this year anyway, it's only the birds that land in the garden that actually count. Anyway, so that's the end of the RSPB Big Garden Bird Watch for me anyway. And that's it. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to click subscribe, that'd be great. Much appreciated. And I'll be back in the next week or two with Pete's Garden episode 5. But it's bye for now.